Okay, our next speaker is Lindalani Singu, who is a wonderful principal for Possibility. He's part of our Partners for Possibility program. He's a principal at Yeovil Boys Primary School, and he has a wonderfully dedicated staff. So he's going to tell us how he's created that, and a staff that's always looking at how to reach out to community and engage community. So I'm sure he has a very inspiring story for us. Thank you, Lindalani.
Guys, good afternoon. My name is Lindalani Singo. I was appointed in 2009 at UV Boys Primary School. When I was appointed, I think we had learners, about 250 learners. 12 educators were paid by GDE, 4 educators were paid by SGB. And we had but 2 groundwork makers and 2 guys, ladies were doing the cleaning. So I think the language that I'm going to speak to you, most of you understand that being a principal is quite lonely and quite challenging. There's a lot of things that people expect from you. The teachers see you as this monster who's just want to implement the policy. The parents see you as this guy who's just eating the money for school fees. Then the department see you as this puppet that they want to pull the strings to, so that when they come with whatever there is, you just have to answer. Then in 2011, I met Anita. Then she told me about Partner for Possibility. And I think most of you understand when you get partner, the first thing that comes to your mind is the wish list and the money and this and that and that. And I was very excited that, wow, my prayers are going to be answered. So I joined Partner for Possibility. So we were used to that. We had total activity. You know, Boys is one of those old schools. This is about 112. So it's an old school which the community around Roosevelt has changed drastically. It used to be a white, rich, Jewish school, but now it's an African school. And I'm going to deliberate why it's an African school. Every African country that you think of, when they come to South Africa, the only place that they could sit and feel safe is around Roosevelt and Hillbrow. So their place that they will send their kids is in Roosevelt. So when we started from that, our school, most boys and the community, they look at the school differently from what the school is. It was an area where people could not get into. So when I became a principal, I had no partner or no any relationship with the community except the learners and the parent. And that was very, very difficult. So we have to change the face of that. The first thing that we need to do from that too, about the kids that we came to school, a lot of them will come to school very hungry. We approached the department about that. And the department said, you are a fee-paying school. But the one thing that the department did, they don't go and check if there is a fee-paying school, how many kids are paying the school fees. That is a sad part of it. Yes, it's a fee-paying school, but from the 450 boys that I have, about only 58% were paying school fees. And in that 58, only 12% were paying regularly. So the other ones would have to pay when you decided to be operate illegally and said, no report, no money. Then you'll have to pay. So I think I'm going to speak the language that you guys understand. So we started to know what, after this public possibility, we went and turned the school into a community thing. So I was listening very carefully, how would I turn that school, which is an island in the heart of Yeovil, to be a college school? And we're taught that you need to make sure that your school is accessible by the community. But most of us as principals, we think that the community is the parent, and it. As when we call meetings, we find that we only have 12 parents sitting, then after an hour, then we've got 25, then after 12, then you don't even quorum. So we have to turn that around. We started a new project. That is what we really wanted to do. Yes, I'm going to show you what we've done. One, we started to make partners. We went to the community around, talked to the banks, talked to the shops, and started to form partners with those people. As I said, the school had no partner. At the moment, I'm sitting with those partners. Our first partner, it was God First. We went to God First, I said, we want to start a feeding scheme. Our boys come to school hungry. God has said, we are more than helping. These are things that we've done. One, they've given us meat every month to the value of 3,000 rand. Two, they've given us an OT that every Tuesday and every Thursday, the OT come to school. These OT therapists sit down with learners with problems, help them. Three, they started what we call it a reading team on Saturdays. The members of the church come to schools. It's in Rosebank, this church. But they move from Rosebank, come to Uvel, sit with our boys and do the reading. Then we had African Bank, who said to African Bank, we are really struggling. Our parents are not paying the school fees. African Bank says, no, that's no problem. This is what we are doing to do. You give us your newsletter every month. We are going to print your newsletter in our newsletter head. For every newsletter that we print, we give you 50 cents. And that's what we did. Then we had a partner with Open Door Music. Open Door Music is a company that is in the US, that is the United States of America. This guy is one of the topest or the most accurate guitarists you can find. So what you do, you opened what you call it Skype. So you Skype with our learners, then you teach them how to play the guitar in the classroom. Then we had a partner with Eugene. Eugene said, you guys, because we've got a lot of problems at UVA, we are going to give you 5 third year students who are doing welfare, social worker. Then they're going to sit with your learners. You identify the learners, then they are there at school on Wednesday and Friday. So that's what we have. Then we start to run workshops with our teachers, because from that even teachers need workshops. Then we had a goal setting. The reason why we do goal setting, every time department will give you certain days to submit certain issues. You find that you're not meeting the days because teachers are not doing that. So we said, let us teach these people what is goal setting. Why do you need to have goals? Why do you need certain things? Then we run the workshop of goal setting. Then we done time management. Then we done what is learner-centered. At the moment, I don't have any problem with anything that's submitted from this state. In fact, we're one of the schools that when everything is supposed to be submitted, we are submitted 2 weeks before because of those 3 workshops that we've done. Then we had other challenges. Like I said, these are the challenges that we have. I just want to move a bit faster. It's going back, okay. Then we have the issue of parental involvement. Parental involvement, I think, is the most problematic thing to most of us. I was talking about you guys when you have your meetings, you sit for a very long. Our meetings take 1 hour. And when you come to the meeting, this is what you'll find. Our hall are packed. And that's what we have done is that we don't even do what is school issues only. When we have parent meeting, there are 4 things that we do. One, we've got SASA who came to school. And you know what SASA did. SASA talk about how to get grant. Now, because our parents know that there is barrel, then they come in numbers. We have home affair. I told you that we're at Uvel. Most people in Uvel, they don't have paper. I'm going to use the language that they use. They talk about the issue of paper. You want this, I don't have that paper. You want this, I don't have paper. So to them, everything is paper. So we called home affair to come with the paper issue. So when the home affair is there, then they come in numbers, because they know what is happening. Then we introduce the issue of reading book. One of the parents donated this thing, studies thing, and we started a reading problem because we had a lot of boys who were coming from different areas. English being a language, but it was a problem. So we had to find a way to cap that. And that's why we started. Then we got City Park and Nedbank. These were the people who come and join us to edify to the feeding scheme. Then we started the gardening. In terms of City Park, when we go to Johannesburg Zoo, we only pay transport as you realize. The entrance is free because of the partnership we have. And this is the tunnels, spinach, I think some of you could benefit from it, where we are going to do spinach for the tunnel. It's planted here, the kids plant this, and then from that we feed them. Now, how do we build the teams in the school? One thing that we found out is to identify people with potential in different areas. Then we started committees in those areas. And each person in that community sit in the SMT. When we said we are having our SMT meetings, it's not only the principal, the HOD, and the deputies. Every coordinator of the committee, sit in the same tea. So whatever we discuss, it becomes part of it. So that has helped us a lot, because I no longer argue with the sports master why sports is not happening, because he's sitting in the same team. He discusses whatever we agreed upon, he take it back. So ladies and gentlemen, like I said, I think the slides are showing you exactly what we are doing. But for you guys to become part of this, there are two things that I can request you to do. One, be open-minded. The person that you're going to have as a partner is your thinking person. I know that they're not becoming with checks and everything, but you can bounce your idea with them. You can talk to them. They are going to show you a lot of things. I was very fortunate because my partner, that is my partner, she's a life coach. So we have a lot of meetings. We have become like family because we now visit each other. Even after hours, we sit and we talk. And that's what I'm encouraging to you to do, that the partner that you're going to have, it must not be just a partner during the day. Make a good relationship with them. Because these people are in industries that we are not in, they know better. And for us to turn our school to be like business people, we need to be close in contact with these people. And for that, I want to thank you.